the short downtime there, we were having some camera issues. Didn't get hit or anything, just a small technical problem, but we are back up here. While we were gone, the score does update here. Score is now 1-1, so I will update that on the board for you. My apologies for the technical problems. A little bit of confusion on what the call is here. Refs are being kind of quiet because they're not sure, it sounds like. But let's see if they can make a call for us. So they did rule a catch. So the clarification here, I can't clarify here. I was able to hear enough of the ref's call. What it is two balls hit one player. First ball hit him and he caught the second one, but the first ball was still live. So that is the ruling. It brings us to 2-2. It's Gage, who's a rock star player, against someone whose first line of dodgeball is today. And she just took out Grace! It's just Jessica, the new girl. And that was an out. All right. Brings us to 2-1. In favor of cold cuts. Dodgeball is a co-ed sport here at our local Cactus Dodgeball. I will say, though, the all-women's team is doing very well. Uh-oh. Bryce being very nice, didn't take the throw at the player without it, then catches her. Allen follows, takes out Katie in that left corner. Big plays, and Bryce is being a nice person. Saw that she had kind of stumbled and didn't want to annihilate someone point blank. Five minutes and about 45 seconds left in the first half. These are 20-minute games, so there will be a 20-minute half. The teams will switch sides. Oh, no. Rachel got out in that exchange. That's not good. Smoking Racks did lose their two best corners. Oh, beautiful job! Hits Grace, pops up, and Carla with the catch. All right, going to be on cold cuts to throw. They have five players left with four balls. Ladies have six players on the court with two balls. Does take out two players there. That was Jess and Asia there that got hit. Gage taking a throw on Grace. She dodges. Ladies are down to four players, so now Blue has one player advantage. Derek takes a throw there, doesn't connect. See if they can call a play here with the three of them. All right, blue team, the cold cuts, has four balls again. Oh, Carla with a long throw hitting the young lady on the back line. What game awareness. Unfortunately, Carla did get traded out for that, though. Smokin' Racks has four balls. Gage takes the quick counter, catches someone not looking. So cold cuts, four balls, four people left against the two players left. Oof. Emily looked for that catch after the block. All right, two balls thrown at the corner. Doesn't connect. Smokin' Racks will have four balls now. Oh, excuse me, they have five balls. There was one way out of bounds coming in. Gage having the last ball for cold cuts. Throws it and then gets countered. Doesn't connect. So Smokin' Racks are back to four balls. Cold cuts have two balls coming in. They throw one at Gage. Nothing there. He doesn't connect. And there it is. The 1-2 from the corners. Gage and Derek each taking one player out there. Brings our score to 3-1. All right, about 3 minutes left on the clock. Again, a very quick pitch back. All right. Bryce gets traded for Jessica in that opening rush. Rachel takes a shot at Gage. Gage jumps and bends backwards. He ultra matrix that. Usually the matrix, you got to have 2 feet on the ground, and he did that in the midair. Very, very awesome. Gage takes a throw. Another ball follows. Allen gets countered in the exchange. Gage takes Katie and Rachel out. My goodness.
I've been getting cross-corner countered all game. We got to hit them.
Holy cow. Gage just is 3-for-3 right now in his outs, taking out huge players. There's a fourth. Oh, he can miss. My goodness. Passing the last ball to Gage, saying, hey, you've been hitting everything. You just went 4-for-5 with throws. That was very impressive. Ladies with four balls. One thrown at Doug and one thrown at Gage. They didn't cross. They just kind of pinched in with that throw. Cold Cuts has 3 balls here with 5 players left on the court. Gage is still on the court, which is a problem. One hits the ground. One just goes over Emily's head as she's on the ground there on her playing small ball. Ladies have 5 balls again. Emily got Gage there and got Derek. There it is. Just like that, the ladies bring it 2-3. They're only down one player right now. It's on Cold Cuts to throw. They do have a plus one player right now. 2 balls thrown, nothing connected. It's going to be reset to blue. Emily with a quick throw. Doesn't connect. That new player does get a block. This is her first day, the young lady in the purple pants. It's her first day of dodgeball right now. So she just blocked beautifully. All right, 2 balls thrown into the gentleman in the corner. He manages to dodge both. Blue team has a 4th ball coming in off the sideline. 1 ball thrown. Emily takes the counter. Oh, no, I don't know what happened there. Oh! Cold Cuts does pull it out. Brings us to 4-1. You know, the score is 4-1, but these ladies are close every single game. I hear multiple players stressing out about how close these games are. If Gage had not taken 4 people out with 5 balls, he would have... See the refs saying the clock is, or the player saying the clock went off. What are you doing throwing the ball? So now that the clock has expired, we're going to play no blocking. If you block the ball, you are immediately out. So it's very important not to block at this point. You see Katie drop a ball. Lots of people dropping balls so they don't accidentally block. Allen takes out Emily there with no response. Allen did get Katie there as well. Again, unable to ladies unable to do anything. There it is. Rachel takes the cross. And Gage, there it is. Those ladies needed those outs. Those corners are very powerful. Oh. Look at that new player all the way up to that green line. No fear. Carla staying alive through 3 balls. Bryce takes a shot at Grace, straight to the ground. Ladies have 4 balls left, 4 players left, going into 6 players from Cold Cuts. Doug taking out Asia there. All right, ladies lost 1 player there. Cold Cuts with 4 balls. Again, this is overtime, so no blocking allowed. They do get Carla there with 2 balls. Cold Cuts down to 2 balls now. Doug doesn't mind. Oh! Jess, well done by Jess. Doug takes out Grace, and Jess immediately had the counter. Jess looking for the catch. Bryce tried to put it high and outside to try and get her to catch, and she didn't. And there it is. Brings us to 5-1 at the half. Teams are now going to switch sides, so I will adjust the score and the names here for you. All right, there we go. 5-1 at the half. Now, again, ladies are not up right now, but every single game, they are very, very close. All right, right now we are taking a short break, probably less than 2 minutes. You can see the ladies are taking their powwow, talking strategy, trying to figure out what they need to do to beat this co-ed team. While we're at halftime, I would like to thank all my local sponsors for hearing us and everyone here in Phoenix, Arizona, and what we appreciate about them because they do so much to support us. And make dodgeball possible here in Arizona. Big thank you to EvoAZ.com, the real estate ninjas with the Waterstone mortgage team. They have supported us here for a couple years now. We really, really appreciate them. Dodgeball is not possible without sponsors like them. Also, big thank you to Dodgeball Live, formerly Dodgeball TTV, but it is rebranded now, Dodgeball Live. And they support everything across the world to bring dodgeball to every player everywhere, and we really appreciate their partnership as well, so we can have a live stream so people at home can watch and support. So if you love dodgeball, give a following is free. It's just an email login. Subscribing gets you out of ads from the Twitch channel. It's about $5 a month. So if you want to not watch ads from the Twitch channel, I totally understand it. It's terrible. ruins a little bit of that live effect. Here we go. And we're off. Second half is now going. Ladies throwing into the corner with Gage. Trying to take out me as the commentator here. Rachel charging into Gage, trying to get him to back off. She does a great job. Ladies have a fourth ball coming in from the stands. There it is. Carla takes the shot, goes just a little high. All right. Four balls on cold cuts to throw. Quick call. Or no, they only have three. I thought they had four. Does catch Emily there. Rachel with a big throw. Carla with a great block, protecting Rachel. What a beautiful job by Carla. Oh, beautiful, beautiful. Let's watch that again. That was huge. Rachel with a huge, huge throw. See if we got that instant replay on slow-mo here. There's the block from Carla. Okay, she passes. Rachel takes it. Charges up, throws, and drop catch. That's beautiful. That is just beautiful.
Ow.
Right outside the camera, you see Doug get the catch and fall out of bounds. That was beautiful done by Doug. Leaves just Jess in. Does get an out from the back line, catching Derek unaware. And there it is, 6-1. All right, while we're resetting, I'm going to watch that again. Just regular speed, though. Here we go. Blocked by Carla, protecting Rachel here in the corner. Rachel picks up the ball, takes a throw. Gage throws at her. She drop catches. Freaking gorgeous. All right, here we go. Again, the men are really coming in fast. Oh! Another awesome job by the ladies. Great coverage, great game awareness. 2 balls thrown from the middle. Carla just didn't connect there. Reload, though. Run it back. They now have the advantage of that back wall. Rachel just takes the shot. Oh, and Katie takes a shot. Carla doing a great job blocking, staying alive through all that. All right. It's on the ladies. They have the player advantage right now. Katie with a huge underhand. Doesn't connect. Oh. Oh. Players knowing exactly what happened there. For those of you at home that might have just kind of not quite caught up, Rachel threw a ball at Allen in the cross court. Allen catches it. And then in the process, Gage tries to counter her, and she catches Gage. But she was already an out player at that time. Ladies being so smart here, they see that the 2 balls for the cold cuts are trapped, and they're unable to get them. Now that Asia takes a shot, that takes out Gage. There's a throw from Jess. Jess gets out in the cross. It's a one-for-one trade. Cold cuts are down to 3 players. They have Doug, Derek, and I don't remember the other gentleman's name at the moment. I do apologize. They do get Katie and Emily out in that trade. Ladies still have 4 players in the game, but the guys are reloading there. Okay. Ladies have a +1 player right now. One ball thrown at the middle into Doug. Doesn't connect. Gives Cold Cuts 4 balls again. They'll probably put 2 on somebody. Derek solo throws. Doesn't connect on Grace. Ladies turn to throw again. Again, still have that +1 player advantage. Great game awareness by Derek. He sees the pop-up and gets the catch. That does bring Bryce in. That is Bryce that comes in. That is out of order. That's out of order! That is very out of order. Yes. All right, clarification. What it is Bryce was the first out. But he was already caught in and then got out again, which put Allen as the first person out. That is brutal. Refs did temporarily pause the call. So they're about 22 seconds ahead of me. That is not worth stopping the clock, but sometimes players can drag this on, so it's not a bad idea to pause it any time. Hey, Yeah, bringing Alan Scott back in is definitely a problem. I can understand why the ladies would be upset with that. That's not good for them. Ladies are down one player, but Alan is definitely worth more than the average player. Doug counters Asia. They are not able to get Alan out. Alan charges back, takes out Grace. Ladies have one player left. Alan takes the throw. That's it. That's rough. That ricochet catch punished them hard. It's a shame, too, because they were winning that game. And that one unlucky ricochet catch just punishes them so hard. Catches are a strong two-for-one in this game, and sometimes it's just bad luck. Yeah, Jess was ready for that quick pitchback. It will be on the gentleman, and cold cuts to throw. They do get the one out there. It's Doug taking the throw there. Doug reloads. Gage makes the call. Nice two-for-one. Then they got Doug. And now Gage. That's huge. Oh, man. Holy cow, the lady started out so strong with some big outs, and Alan has just fought his way into saying, I'm going to take them all out back. It's insane. They got some huge outs with Doug and Gage, and who else did they get out? They got three guys out in that opening rush, and then Alan just said, throw. I'm here to win this game. Carla tried to catch him off guard. Carla with a catch and out! What a play. Let's watch that again here. Might have been just outside of camera, but we'll see here. See if we can get that instant replay. Oh, it is just outside of camera. I do apologize, but those two balls, she's able to catch one of the two. So that was a beautiful exchange. Alan tries to take out Emily. Emily's unable to duck under it. Does a great job not chasing the ball. Cold Cuts has advantage here with a plus one player. But it's Allen plus the exchange there. All right. Smoking Racks here with four balls. They're probably putting them on Allen. Oh, they put one on Allen, one on the other corner. All right. Emily Fishman, last player standing here. Emily with two balls right now. All right, brings us to 7-1. Excuse me, 8-1. There's about 10 minutes left, 10 minutes and 5 seconds on the head clock. Bryce with a great catch at that opening rush. Another great play by Bryce today. See if we can watch that again really quick before anything else happens here. Instant replay that. Here's the opening rush. Bryce takes a throw, catches Jess at his ankles. Beautifully done. Two balls hitting Doug there. Allen with a quick counter into Asia. Doug's taking a one for one there. Probably not the best player to trade with, but sometimes you got to take your trades. Two balls thrown, getting Emily out there. Allen taking the throw. Allen then drop and catches. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Watch that again here. Here's his throw. Takes her out and drop catches. Absolutely stunning. Carla throws one, goes in high. Gage charging. Thank you. Derek with a great throw on Grace's ankle there. Carla, last hero standing here against four balls. Survives. Dodges two and blocks one. Carla with a long shot. Doug just barely catches it. Carla throwing a few more just for good measure. You can hear everybody laughing. This is Rec League, so people like to have some fun sometimes. It is a good time. All right, that brings us to 9 minutes. 9-1, and the refs just said 9 minutes left on the clock. So I'm about 40 seconds behind them, 30 seconds behind them, ahead of them. Allen signaling. You see that? Great sportsmanship. Katie throws and catches Allen's forearm. We really appreciate player honesty here. There is so much going on, guys. Got to remember, this is 8-on-8 with six balls being played at once. What a throw by Katie Sanchez. Hits Bryce's shoes and then goes out. So there was just nowhere. Bryce could do nothing with that. Target accuracy like crazy. Emily charging. Katie right behind her. Katie takes the throw and gets Doug. Katie has gotten three huge outs. She took out Allen. She took out Bryce and she took out Doug. She takes a shot at Derek now. Derek blocks, but you can see he is a little worried about it. Katie is showing why she is the Sanchez. All right. Multiple balls thrown at Derek, and they finally get him out. Cold cuts with four players left. The ladies have four players left. Oh, they will just take a quick short pause. A green ball has come on the court. And I won't mention names, but somebody couldn't get it back over the wall. For how strong of an arm she is, she took it real easy there. All right, Cold Cuts now has four balls. They're going to charge back here now. Ball thrown. Emily easily dodges. Great footwork. Katie with a throw. Oh! New player today just got her first catch on the court. That is something pretty awesome and celebrated around here when new players get their first catch of the game. That's huge. Downside is that does bring Allen out. He was definitely first out today. Emily lives through that somehow, just barely. Carla took a blind shot at Gage. Carla with four balls, or no, I'm sorry, Emily's four balls left. Ooh. Allen tries to cross counter and goes high. Emily took a shot towards the middle. Doesn't connect. Oh! Right into her hands, and she couldn't quite collapse on it. And I understand. Those balls come in real fast from Allen. See if the ladies can put up one more point here against this Rockstar team. The ladies are all Rockstar players, but let me tell you, those guys throw a lot faster and can put a lot more movement on the ball that's sometimes a little unfair. I wouldn't want to play against this team. You get Doug in that exchange there. And that's Bryce. For everybody watching at home, regarding the internet issues and the lag, I do apologize. We are in a brick building, trying to stream off of getting two bars in here. I'm sorry, guys. I'm doing the best I can. We are using what is considered to be locally one of the best service providers and still can... Man, I'm sorry, guys. Today, for whatever reason, our internet is just not as good as it should be. Rachel taking a big shot on Doug. Unable to connect. Gage countered. Oh! All right. My clock has expired. Ref head clock has 3, 2, 1. All right. That brings almost to the end of this first game. There are two Gamer games tonight. There is approximately a 7:40 game, which is in about 5 minutes. And then there's an 8:35 p.m. game. So we're doing the best we can with the Wi-Fi we have in here. And I understand if you guys want to not watch live. If you would like to watch at a later time, these videos are also going to be on the Dodgeball Live page after the fact. That's one location. You can also go to Cactus Dodgeball's YouTube page. There's a slightly different angle from the back, and you should be able to see a lot more there. That's a great catch by Asia there, right in front of us. Brings in Jess. Team to hear the ladies celebrating. They have Rachel coming in next. Rachel Baker, who's an awesome player. Ladies are really looking for those catches, but Cold Cuts is bringing up their three best catchers. No! No! Just left. Doesn't quite collapse on the catch. So that is it for game one. I myself am actually going to be playing in the next game, so I will be stepping away. I apologize here. I thought I had a backup commentator while I was playing. Unfortunately, we had a couple of refs go out sick, so players who can commentate are also going to be out. I'm trying to do what I can to get the signal a little better for you guys while I'm gone. I will just have that Cactus Dodgeball banner up for the next game. I will try and pop over here during the next game to let you guys know the score and so forth. Thank you for tuning in. Again, I realize the stream quality today is a little bit more like a photo reel due to data. I apologize. This location or this gymnasium does not offer Wi-Fi. We're using the best tethering we can, hotspot, and we're doing the best we can. I don't want to go into it too much, but we purposely got the best provider, paid a chunk, and I apologize. Unfortunately, at this location, this is all we can do. We are always looking for new locations, though. So if there's a local gym in Phoenix, Arizona that you know that has Wi-Fi and has like to make a deal with us, please reach out to us via social media or anything else. We'd happily like to maybe use a different gymnasium if we can get a better deal with Wi-Fi. And then you guys would have a better stream. So let me know. Otherwise, I'll let you guys watch the next game while I play. I will not be on this tort. I think I'm on the far cart, so I do apologize. You don't get to see me play. But I hope you enjoy the game in front of you, and I'll see you guys in about 40 minutes.
third or fourth personnel. Elijah there, and then you. Okay. Yeah, I'm not.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. have been an out had he not caught it.
Thank you. Yeah, I don't think any of us.
Thank you. chest.
Yeah, throwing chest height into him is not good.
I mean, I did, to be fair, I did hit him in like the hand, and then it just went up.
Yeah, James somehow just gets his hand about everything if it's up here.
Yeah.
Like, you get it low, you're pretty safe, because you look like a gym, but Alex is easy to just jump, catch in midair. He also throws a lot, he's too aggressive.
Ready, one, two! Ready, one, two!
Three!
Yeah. Well, it works really well when we're at the other.
Thank you. Thank you. counter, Alex. Great job. All comes in.
Thank you.
8, and those are going to 2 and going to 7.
Trevor's out!
I just, like, Kendall's never here, so, like, all season long, you're gonna have to just sub him out. I don't think he showed up once yet. So it's been, like, Gage, I think, mostly. And, like, Gage now is still scary as hell, but, like, I definitely think Kendall's worse. So their record probably won't be as scary as other teams, but come tournament time, Kendall's here. My money's on them to win the thing. You got it, Viv. Catch it.
Yeah!
I'm already out!
Yeah. catcher.
Kirsten does make that catch after the flying throw from Axel. Oh, double catches. That is the final game. Final score tonight was 8-4. Thank you for everybody for tuning in and watching. Again, thank you to Dodgeball TTV. I do apologize, everybody. We did have quite a bit of internet issues tonight. I will try and do my best to see if we can do anything better. We are in a brick building, so Wi-Fi and signal are pretty hard to get in here. So we will continue to do the best we can. And again, we also are open to other suggestions with a place with Wi-Fi. But anyway, have a great night. Thank you again, Dodgeball TTV, for allowing us to share this experience together with you here at Cactus Dodgeball. And thank you to our local sponsors. Appreciate you guys making it possible for us to have Dodgeball here in Phoenix, Arizona. We'll be here again next Tuesday. Actually, I think we might be taking a week off. I do apologize. Let me double check the schedule because this is a school, so they have spring break. So we might have 1 week off. Let me check. Let's see where we're at here. Yes, March 12th next week is spring break for school kids. So the school is closed, so we won't be able to use their facilities that week. So it will be 2 weeks before we're streaming again. So not the 12th.